Hello students, this is quick solution of All India Cash test series medical 2020. This is test number 2 for regular medical code E and code F for chemistry conducted on November 17, 2019. Let's start with the first question of chemistry, which is question number 46. In a buffer solution, the concentration of RNH2, where R is alkyl group, and that of RNH3 plus Cl minus respectively are 0.6 molar and 0.4 molar. Then pH of the solution at 298 Kelvin is, and we are given with Kb for RNH2, which is 10 to the power minus 5. The options are 4.82, 8.24, 8.76 or 9.18. Student, as it is very clear that a given buffer is a basic buffer, and for that we have a formula to calculate pOH. I'm writing it. pOH is equals to P Kb plus log concentration of salt upon concentration of base. Since we know the value of pKb, which is minus log Kb plus log salt is RNH3 plus upon RNH2, which is the base, minus log, the value of Kb is 10 to the power minus 5, plus log, the concentration of salt is 0.4 molar, and the concentration of base is 0.6, which gives a total of 4.82. Students, here we have to calculate pH, and for that the formula used is pH is equals to 14 minus pOH. The value of pOH we have already calculated, which is 4.82. That gives a total of 9.18. That means the correct answer for this question is option number 4. Moving to question number 47. The ionization constant of an organic acid, RCOOH, at 25 degrees Celsius is 10 to the power minus 6. The equilibrium constant of hydrolysis of RCOO minus is 10 to the power minus 10, 10 to the power minus 6, 10 to the power minus 14 or 10 to the power minus 8. So students, I'm writing the reaction of hydrolysis of RCOO minus. RCOO minus plus water equilibrium RCOOH plus OH minus. Here, the equilibrium constant, which is the hydrolysis constant KH, is equals to KW, which is ionic product of water, upon KA, which is acid dissociation constant. The acid is RCOOH. The value of KW is 10 to the power minus 14, and the value of KA is already given, is 10 to the power minus 6. The value of KH becomes 10 to the power minus 8. That means the correct answer for this question is option number 4. Moving to question number 48. 2 moles of an ideal gas undergo reversible isothermal expansion from 2.303 liter to 23.03 liter at 27 degrees Celsius. The change in entropy is, the value of R is already given, which is 8.314 joule per mole per Kelvin, and the options are 38.3 joules per Kelvin, 16.6 joules per Kelvin, 4.6 joules per Kelvin or minus 4.6 joules per Kelvin. So let's proceed the question, students. Students, as we all know, for reversible isothermal expansion of an ideal gas, the value of delta S is equals to Nr into 2.303 log base 10 V final upon V initial. Since the value of N is 2, we are already given 2 moles. We are already given with the value of R, which is gas constant, which is 8.314 into 2.303 log base 10. The value of V final is 23.03 and the value of V initial is 2.303. So, 23.03 upon 2.303. Which gives a total value of 38.29 joules per Kelvin. That means the correct answer for this question is option number 1. Moving to next question. Slope of graph of compressibility factor Z with pressure P for hydrogen gas at any pressure is? The options are 1 by RT, B by RT, A by V square or B by R. Students, for 1 mole, the van der Waals equation is P plus A upon V square V minus B is equals to RT. For H2, we all know that molecular attractive forces are insignificant. That means the value of A is approximately 0. As a result, the van der Waals equation becomes P V minus B is equals to RT. Multiplying P in bracket, we get PV minus PB is equals to RT. Let's divide each term by RT. We get PV upon RT minus PB upon RT is equals to 1. We all know that PV upon RT is Z. So Z is equals to 1 plus PB by RT. Comparing this equation with equation of straight line, which is y is equals to mx plus c, we get the value of slope, which is b by RT. That means the correct answer for this question is option number 2. Moving to question number 50. Under identical conditions of temperature and pressure, ratio of rate of effusion of O2 to SO2 is? The options are 1 is to 1, root 3 is to 1, root 2 is to 1, 2 is to 1. So students, let's solve the question. Students, as we all know that at identical temperature and pressure condition, the rate of effusion is inversely proportional to under root of molecular weight. So the rate of effusion of O2 upon rate of effusion of SO2 is equals to under root of molecular weight of SO2 upon molecular weight of O2, which is under root of 64 upon 32. That means under root 2 is to 1 is the correct answer. So, number 3 is the correct option.